Unless you have a decent budget, rain effects can be prohibitively difficult, but thankfully you can use assets like these. It can be tricky to get it right, but nowadays it is a lot easier than you might think to composite rain in post, which is safer. The first step to an effect like this is adding as much water inside your actual shot as possible. That means while you're filming, you're doing as much of a wet down on the ground and the other areas as you can, and hitting your talent with some water as well to get that organic interaction. Otherwise, you get to post, realize it didn't work, and be a sad boy. That little extra in your shot will mean the difference between this and this. In the first, there's no wet down at all, but in the second, those small areas of water do help sell the final effect. However, for this episode, let's take this shot here. This has this glistening floor that almost feels wet, but otherwise this isn't gonna do us any favor. So let's see how far we can take it. And there is a few main things to keep in mind for this shot, like roto on our actors so we can place rain behind them. It's also a moving shot, so we'll do a motion track, and we can see the ground in the shot, so we're gonna need to comp in some rain surface interaction there. So on a duplicate, we'll double click the layer, then use the roto brush tool to select both actors and refine until we have what we want. Now we'll play through and adjust areas if needed, then freeze the effect to lock it in. After that, we're gonna create a null, then with our main layer selected, we'll go to our tracker, set our point, track motion, then apply that data to our null. To add in the actual rain, we'll need stock footage, which you can get from a number of different places. These specific ones came from actionvfx.com, and assets like these are usually shot with a black background. So to get rid of that, we're gonna set each layer's blending mode to screen like so. Now we'll link to our null, which has our tracking data, then playing through the shot to make sure the edges of the rain layer never show in frame. If they do, we'll scale up as needed. Then using a curves effect, we're gonna add some contrast here to define the raindrops and remove that flat look. Now we'll move on to the ground, using an asset like this to give us those interactions there. So we'll place, then mask any sections needed, and again, link this track to our null and make sure the edges remain beyond the frame. In this specific instance, we can hide an edge behind the actor and use a duplicate for the other half of the frame, which lets us scale the asset down more so it feels farther from camera. Then we'll use another ground asset even more in the distance. On this one, we'll add a camera lens blur and boost the value to closer match our footage. Now we'll copy this effect to the other ground interactions, but lower the value a bit since these are supposed to be closer to the camera. Also keep in mind that the more surfaces in your shot obviously mean the more rain interactions you need to add, including water dripping down where needed to add that realism. And realism is what we want. Otherwise, you get to the end of your shot, realize it looks like crap, and be a sad boy. Next, we want to add some depth, so we'll use a new rain asset placed on top of the comp and repeat the same steps as we did with the other assets. Then we'll duplicate this and scale up to look like it's closer to the camera. And we're going to move it in the timeline so it starts at a new frame for variation from the other. Then we're going to use a camera lens blur effect again to knock it out of focus. With any effect, it's always smart to grab some real-world references as a guide while you build. So if we look at these, you'll see that the rain is not evenly visible across the entire image, and is only strong around these light sources. We can replicate this by first duplicating the track and moving one beneath the roto, then we'll pre-compose the first set of rain layers and track together as rain background. Then link the top rain to the new track and pre-comp these layers as rain foreground. Now create an adjustment layer beneath the roto, add a fast box blur effect, and boost the amount high. We'll use a curves effect to lift the brightness and add some contrast, then set this layer to use our rain comp as a luma mat and change the blending mode to screen. And we're now seeing the rain more visibly around the brightest areas of our image. And you can see from these lights that we're also getting the correct colors in the rain too. Then you can adjust your blur or curves to fine tune, or even use a curves on the rain pre-comp for further control if needed. But for more directional lights, you can use a duplicate of either the rain or adjustment layer and draw effects feathered mask in a shape that feels correct for the light source. But now with the duplicate of the adjustment layer moved above the roto, we'll change the matte to use the rain foreground and adjust the curves effect again slightly. If you want some highlights to catch, you can use duplicates of the rain comps, make them visible, set to screen, and crush the curves to only get the fine highlights to appear. And to get some displacement on the ground, similar to what we can see in the real examples, we can use another adjustment layer and an effect like vector blur. Choose our rain background comp, boost the value, and change some settings before adding a motion tile effect placed first. Then check mirror edges and boost the width and height to remove this gap at the edge of the frame. Then we'll mask and feather to keep it visible only in certain areas of the ground, or we use another copy placed above the roto layer with a lower vector blur amount to get very slight displacement across the full frame too. And here we have our final shot. But like I said at the top, while I do think we made this work, to take it to 100%, you really want genuine interaction on your talent. We're getting away with it here because they're largely in shadow, but if they were fully lit, this would not work at all. So if you're planning to add rain in post, make sure to wet down the area you're shooting in as much as possible and hit your talent with some hose water or whatever so you can fully sell the effect. But that is it for today. Links to everything we talked about below. And as always, if there's something you would like to see us cover in the future, let us know in the comments below. And subscribe to the channel for more tutorials and updates like this one. Don't make it weird. Just subscribe. I'm not gonna beg. I will. I'm not above it.